Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Santos Capellan Jr. wishing you a good day. Now today what I'm going to do is try to do another approach in programming the supply fun and return fun control logic of our return or recirculating air handling unit. Now in my previous tutorial, I used the combination of different logical gates. Now I use there an AND gate and combine it with the NOT gate. Okay. Now here in this another approach for programming this start stop of supply and return fan of this air handling unit, I'm using now an expression block. Okay. Now expression block. Okay. Now you can use expression block with binary output. Okay. As you can see here, this is expression block. With binary output, okay? Now, you can use also expression block with integer output, okay? Now, you can use also binary block, expression block with a real output, okay? Now, you know already the difference between integer and real output, okay? Now, for the beginners, integer, it will produce a whole number or integer output value, okay? Now for real, it will produce a floating point or a value which has a fractional part or decimal part. Okay, if it is a binary output, it could be one or zero only. Now this time, I will be using an expression block binary output. Okay, now if you are using expression block binary output, this one, the conditions should be written in small letters. Okay. Now let me explain to you what are these condition. Okay. Now my expression block here, this is SF RF conditions, or this is the condition that needs to be met so that this block will give an output of one. Okay. Now what are the condition? Okay. I have here actually there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have 5 inputs in my expression block. Okay. So the inputs are all binary. Okay. So when I say binary, it could be 0 or 1, true or false. Okay. Now, so what is the expression? It says here this exclamation point represents the NOT gate. NOT A, then we are using for the logical end, we are using this ampersand symbol. Okay, so the condition is like this. Okay, let me zoom this, zoom in. Okay, so that okay, let me zoom in. Okay, now I think that is the real. I cannot make it a little more, a little bit bigger. Okay, anyway. It is it can be read, okay, anyway, it is readable. Okay, so let me just continue with the expression. So meaning not A, okay, meaning not A. Okay, so fire alarm, not fire alarm, so meaning there's no fire alarm. And okay, now and B, so B is our hand of auto status. Okay, so and B, meaning and B is true. And C, so and C, so C input is the return fan hand of auto status, okay, and not D or not trip supply fan trip status, and not return fan trip status, okay. So that is how are you going to write your expression. So basically, this is just a combination of not and end gates, okay. So let me repeat. Not A, no fire alarm, and B, hand up auto for supply pan is true, and C, return pan hand up auto status is true, and not D, and there is no trip status in supply pan, and not E, there is no trip status in the return pan. If it is true, then I will use the output of this for another expression block. Now this time I have here an expression block with three inputs. Okay, so the output of this expression block, I'm using as one of the inputs here. So what is the expression? A and B and C. So meaning all these conditions should be true before I can give a one or a binary output of one. Okay, so what are the other inputs here for this second expression block? So this is now the software input points. Okay, that will be coming from my BMS graphics. So time schedule, okay, time schedule is true. If the output of this expression block is true, and time schedule is true, and operator enable is true, then give me one, then the output will be one. Okay, so if this is the output is one, meaning this binary output will be one also, then this time delay will start to count whatever is the on delay specified. Then after that time delay, then this return fun start stop command will be one. From here, your supply fun startup command is already true. Okay, so I put here a time delay for the return fun because I don't want supply fun and return fun start at the same time. Okay, so this is another approach instead of using combination of AND, NOT, or gates. Then you can use an expression block. Okay, so there are three types of expression block. Expression block binary, expression block integer, expression block real. So if it is expression block binary, it will produce an output of binary output. Okay, if it is real expression block, then it will produce a real output. If it is an integer expression block, it will produce an integer output. Okay, so let's see how we are going to simulate this. We will see if it will okay, and then let me execute. Okay, now okay, let me initialize all the input points. Okay, as you can see here, okay, let me go out of the way. Now it's already working, or we are already simulating it. Now let's see how this functional block programming works. Okay, now first for my physical input, I have to make my supply pan and return pan in automatic position. Okay, let me, okay, SF hand of auto, then RF hand of auto. Okay, as you can see here, I'm simulating the points here. Now my binary blocks are showing the actual what you call this one, this is the actual input signal. If it is one or zero, now what you can see here, okay, this is already one, meaning the selector switch is already in automatic. Okay, now I have an expression block here. My expression block here is already, the output is already one, okay, because it met the condition. It met the condition for A, B, C, D, and E. Now this expression here is already met. That's why the output is one. Okay, now this expression block here is not yet, the output is still zero, as you can see here. Now what are the conditions that this expression block will give a one output? First, A should be true, and B should be also one, and C should be also one before it will give one. Okay, as you can see here, we are not giving one signal to the system healthy, and the supply pan and return pan has not yet started. Okay, now so we have to satisfy this expression block. Okay, so to satisfy this one, I have to simulate the time schedule. So time schedule, I will change it to one, meaning the fan will run based on the time schedule set in that particular time. Let's say from 8 to 5, from 8 it will start, then 5 it will stop. So meaning this time schedule is within that period. Okay, now operator enable, okay, let's say operator enable is one. Okay, then as you can see here, immediately our control logic program started the funds. Okay, now let's simulate. There is fire alarm. Okay, I will put fire alarm. As you can see here, our control logic remove its command to the supply pan and return pan, okay, because there is fire alarm. You know the reason for that. Now let me remove the fire alarm. Okay, immediately our control logic program will restart the fan. Okay, now let's simulate a trip in any of the pans. Let's say I will simulate a trip here in my supply pan. Okay, now as you can see, our system or our program shut down the AHU plant. Okay, so let me remove the trip. Okay, let me remove the trip, supply pan trip. Okay, as you can see again, our control logic restarted the air handling unit. So this is the different approach from programming the fans of air handling unit. First approach, we use the combination of logical gate and or not. Okay, now if you want to get rid of this combination of logical gates, you can use an expression block as I have shown you here. Now sometimes it's better to use this expression block. Just be very careful in writing your expression. Okay, so you have to follow the correct expression, and you have to know if you are using expression block binary or expression block integer or expression block real. Okay, now if you are using expression block binary, the condition or your expression should be written in small letters. Okay, A, B, C, and D. Okay, so this is how you are going to program your air handling unit start stop using expression block. I guess I have given you the idea or the difference between a combination of logical gates and expression block. Okay, so once again, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe so that you can support my YouTube channel and my wish to teach new engineers and engineering student building management or building automation system. You can also click the notification bell. And once again, thank you very much, and God bless us all. And Santos Capellan Jr. saying bye for now.